Hey everybody, how's it going? I'm going to show you my favorite camera accessory. It's dirt cheap, used all the time, and super fantastic. Stick around.
Hey everybody, how you doing? If you like the video, hit subscribe. I appreciate it.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter.
So when it comes to camera accessories, there's a bunch of different things that you can buy. And everything costs money because when it comes to photography, videography, anything like that, it's expensive. Always is. And you'll find it, you know, you'll see the same thing in multiple prices in different places. And you know, you have to kind of get what you need for the situation you're in, or maybe what's useful for you. So this is really useful for me. I use it all the time. Dirt cheap. I love them. And I figured I'd go ahead and share with you what I'm talking about. Bam. Here we go. I have a bunch of these. These things are dirt cheap. They vary in cost. I pay about $7, maybe sometimes a little bit less. And all this is a camera bracket, right? Some people refer to them as flash brackets. Back in the olden days, you'd hook your flash up here. Well, here's the deal. Look, you have two cold shoe mounts right here. There's one, and there's the other. And lo and behold, on the bottom, with this nice little quarter 20 screw that slides back and forth, you have a place to hook up your camera. Bam! So what you actually have here, this is a Canon camcorder. I use these quite a bit. I make YouTube videos. I've been doing it for a little while. And, you know, regardless of what people say, this is absolutely the easiest way to make YouTube videos. And if, you know, people want to disagree, I'll fight you in the backyard. That's all there is to it. Because there's lots of advantages of using a camcorder. Number one, this little camcorder, very small, about the size of a Red Bull can, does 60 frames per second. That's progressive, by the way. Basically has a big giant battery on the back, has a touch screen, because when you flip the screen out, so you can see yourself, you can make your changes, and you can record until the battery is dead in this thing or you run out of memory. And here's the good thing, under $200. These are absolutely the best and easiest ways to make YouTube videos as far as your camera choice. And I don't care what year it is. So, yeah. So if you want to do it easily, you get one of these. But here's the scoop, though. These do have their limitations, and one of which is there is no place to be able to hook up something. Right? And see, the good thing about the camcorders that I use, like this one in particular, there is an external microphone input right here. Where is it? There it is. Right there. I can hook up an external microphone or headphones or whatever I want and plug it right in. And with that, I can monitor my audio, maybe sweeten my audio, maybe make it sound a little bit better. Problem is, where do I put the microphone? Nowhere to hook it up. That's where this comes in. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Such a simple thing. This little bracket right here, right? I have my camera attached to it. Very nice. See what I'm saying here? Look, here's what it looks like. Can you dig it? There's my camera. Look at that. Now I've given myself a handle. Here's the deal, left-handed, right-handed, doesn't matter because you can just rotate the camera wherever you want. So what I actually have now is, since this camera is so small, I still have a slightly small camera rig here. I have a nice little handle for stability, but more importantly, I have two cold shoes. Here's one and here's the other where I can actually hook an optional accessory up. Like for example, maybe a light or maybe a microphone. Okay, so here's the microphone. I did a review on this a little while ago, so if you want to watch that video, it's in my playlist. But here we go, see? Cold shoes, cold shoe, ready? Yeah, there it is. Go ahead and make sure that, you know, you snug it up. That's what this ring is for right here. There you go. And look, what? It's my microphone. It's an external microphone. Looks kind of silly, doesn't it? But look. See what I got here? Hey, looks like I'm wearing one of those hats, like I'm a British guard or something. But anyway, look, you have your microphone, and you also have the camera. And here's the deal. You can record and do what you want. Now, the good thing about this particular setup is that maybe you don't want it like that. Maybe you don't like it like that. Well, you have a whole other cold shoe. So just take it and put it in the other cold shoe. Slide it in. Whoa, can't see. Got too much wind muff in the way, otherwise known as dead cat. Look, now it's on the side. Look a little bit better. Yeah, there you go. There's my camera. See, with this setup right here, I paid like $7 for this. I have like five of these things. So I can pretty much hook it up any way I want. You know? And also, on the bottom of these guys, there's another quarter 20 hole. So you could actually, I fastened this to a tripod or something like it. Or if you want to go a little bit bigger, maybe you want to disperse your grip. Spread it out. Look at all that room you got there. So effectively, seriously, for like $7 to $9. Sometimes they're more than that. I wouldn't pay any more than that in these. You can make yourself a little micro camera rig right there. Yeah, and you know, basically feed it up and plug it in. Now I can record audio, and I still have room for a light if I want. It's such a silly thing, and I know there's been lots of videos on these brackets out there. I just figured I needed to do it. And also, in my last video where I did a review on this microphone, I never really said anything about the bracket or how I had it connected. So, and since I did use Canon camcorders quite a bit, unless it has a cold shoe mount on the top somewhere or an advanced accessory shoe, there's really no way to connect anything. So that's kind of what I was using. That's the point of this little cheesy video. So, yeah. So if you think this has been useful, a little thumbs up would be super nice. If you want to leave a comment, that'd be super nice. If you'd like to give me some suggestions for some videos, super nice. But either way, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. And yeah. Oh, one more thing. There are also different styles of brackets you could use. This is just basically a standard camera bracket. You normally buy these. They come with two of these. So you can connect together to almost make like a DSLR cage or a camera cage. Different size holes. However, no cold shoe attachments. But they actually have these. You can buy them. See? Look at that. It's a cold shoe, and it's, you guys hear that wind? It's a cold shoe, and basically just attaches right there, and you've added a cold shoe to it. Can you guys hear that? Man, I hope you guys can hear that. What that was a 65 mile per hour gust blown against the house, because desert, man. Wind. Desert. But yeah, anyway, you could buy stuff like this for dirt cheap. And these little brackets, they usually come too. I think they're like $12 to go total. And you can put it together and make a little cage if you want. So maybe if you don't want the camera bracket that has a little bit of an angled holder to it and want to go something a little bit smaller, you can certainly do that. But yeah, so you can hook any microphone, any light, anything you want up to basically any camera that has a tripod screw hole in the bottom of it, which is ¼-20, by the way, for most of them, for dirt cheap. So hope it's useful. Thumbs up if you like this video. Comments, suggestions, all that good stuff, leave them. But very much appreciated. See you later. Take it easy. Bye-bye.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like...